sit and we breathe in the cool salty air. You turn to me with a kiss in your eyes, and my heart feels a thrill beyond compare.
I'm going to be having a casual smoke in the garage because it's like 21 degrees right now outside. A little too cold to be trying to focus on keeping my pipe lit and just enjoy the whole experience and talking to you guys. Smoking my lumberman style Savinelli. I think it's 801, but I'll throw the specs up on the screen right now. Shooting in cinematic mode today. I don't really know what that pertains to, but it's in 4K at 30 frames a second. So, it's pretty good. Be smoking Peter Stokeby's Luxury Twist. Luxury Twist Flake, not just. Already, broke it up. I did that because it was a little moist, so I broke it up and then let it set in this jar for a bit. It's super cozy in here, guys, like comparatively to just sitting outside and freezing my A off. It's like it's night and day. Big old pile of premium tobacco right there. It's super exciting to see the development in cinematography and everything. Dang, keeps texting me, jeez. So awesome. It's currently Sunday. Hope you guys are having a good Sunday. So find the time on a nice Sunday to come in here and enjoy a pipe with you guys. So blessed. Right there, if you'll stay somewhere. Picked up this nice, I forgot what brand it is, but it's called a t-shirt jacket. That is really, really good. Peter Stokeby, what can I say? Amazing, amazing brand. This isn't a review, tobacco review, but I would highly recommend picking up the Luxury Twist Flake if you are running low and or are hoarding tobaccos. Pick up some, it's amazing. It's super good, especially if you give it the time to really age and dry out. And you, some people like to break up their tobacco fresh from the block, and I do occasionally, but letting this one in particular sit out, already broken up, amazing. The old pipe's running perfectly cool. Don't even feel any heat, residual heat coming from the burrow section here into the stem. Yeah, it doesn't get better than this setup right now, so super excited. I might, especially when the heat of the summer comes up and it gets really frustrating to do videos outside with the constant moving around in the neighborhood, I might just come back in here, just switch up my setup with the AC instead of the heater. We'll see. I didn't want to do it in here at first because I need to organize the crap. Do some spring cleaning for sure. So, but I was able to clear enough of a wall to get this video in. It's getting blown up right now. I have plans in 2 hours, so I set this video as a goal today, not to just like rushing it done, but to make it a reality to get it done, because I really appreciate the comments from the last video, and all around just getting back into this channel has been such a blessing. Super fortunate to have the time to be able to do these videos. So I was like, man, let's do another one. Let's make it a cozy video. Let's make it a well-rounded video, and let's put my best step forward in terms of making a quality video for you guys. So, man, this Peter Stokeby is burning so good, man. I really enjoy this pipe, the rustication on it, the light reds in there, dark red, smooth on the top, orange-ish, reddish wood band at the top, surrounded by two gold bands around that. Anyways, I wanted to share a segment with you guys really quick. I don't have any stories today, so we won't do story time, but I have an unboxing for you guys, so check that out, and I'll see you when you get back here. Wanted to do a YABO here because I got home from work and seen this box in the mailbox. And it's from smokingpipes.com. I don't know if you can see that. My camera's been really iffy lately, but open it up with this army green-ish Kershaw auto. And I'll tell you why they call it an auto. That is super fast for a small knife. It's compared to a Gerber in terms of price and all that. So if you're looking for a good small like utility knife, box opening knife, YABO opening knife, I would go with this one. It's awesome. I just love it. I was gifted to me by a coworker, so yeah, super blessed there. But anyways, let's get into this box right here because I'm super excited to share with you what I picked up. I picked up on New Year's, and the story behind this was, so I decided to order me some on New Year's, and the options were like $9 or $10 for shipping on standard shipping, or like $5 for express shipping, which is faster. And I was just like, Yeah, let me just pay cheaper amount, and on top of that, have my package arrive faster. Like, that's awesome. Got it open. Here we go. There's paper on top. Some bubble wrap. Shout out to Smoker Friendly. They've always been on time with my deliveries and stuff. Good tracking information. Customer service has always been amazing when I've had questions. And I always have a lot of questions, but and I get majority of my pipes to them. I did not get a pipe in this YABO, but that will be coming soon. I've seen some cool stuff that I'm excited to share with you soon. But I did get this package here. And so in this package is two of the 1926 Padron sticks. This series stick is my favorite series of stick from Padron, because one, Padron's my favorite brand. And I need to count for how many times I'm going to say Padron in this YABO, but yeah, seriously, guys, they've been in the industry since like the beginning of the ages, and I've smoked many, many different cigars. I go to the lounge quite often with my friends, and we'll have some sticks there. I'll have some bowls of from different pipes and stuff like that. But yeah, this is just my go-to when I can find them. They're just so amazing. I can't find them anywhere though. So I've been ordering them online when I get a chance. I'll show you this. This is my acrylic jar for my acrylic. It's actually an acrylic humidor, and this acrylic humidor and the one that the camera is sitting on, I have two of them, are the best purchase I've ever had if you're looking for if you're looking to humidate your cigars. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoy the video, and that's the YABO for today. Thanks. So yeah, I got those two cigars in. I was going to go to the lounge yesterday, but my friend has really bad tongue bite right now because he just got into pipes, and unfortunately, that's at least the way I went into them. That's the way I got it too. I just was learning how to pack and how to smoke, and I'm still a really fast smoker, but luckily the pipes I own kind of balance that out a bit, and I've learned some techniques over the way. One of them is, he obviously already knew this one, but just always having a drink with you really, really helps, even if it's just water, tea. Tea's really good because it has natural healing properties that will help keep your tongue all safe. To take you to the lounge someday, maybe even rent it out, get all my buddies together and film a video with you guys, because you can do that. You can do your birthday at a lounge, or that's actually one of my plans for this year, is to do a day of getting breakfast, then going to the lounge, having a morning smoke, going fishing, just doing everything that I enjoy doing. Life is too short to not enjoy the things that you enjoy. Alright, guys, well, I'm gonna sit here, enjoy the rest of this pipe, drink the rest of my coffee, and just think of all the good memories going into the new year's. From the past couple years here, all the blessings I've had, all the good friends I've had, all the good trips I've made, and just look forward to the new years with good friends, good company, good new trips going on. There's going to Minnesota next year. I'm going to do some other cool stuff, so of course I'll always take you guys along with me for the ride. And yeah, thanks for a good welcome back. I really appreciate it. Yeah, enjoy the rest of your guys' Sunday. I'll see you in the next one. Poker Piper out. See ya.